coming up in today's video. Follow along as I celebrate the Mid-Autumn Moon Festival with crafts, mooncakes, and much love. It's the morning of the Mid-Autumn Festival. I will be preparing for the festival by creating a few much-needed items to go with my chosen costume. With my craft items prepared in my little pink basket, it's time to hurry home and begin these Mid-Autumn projects. The Mid-Autumn Festival, also known as the Moon Festival, is held on the 15th day of the 8th month of the lunar calendar. Since the lunar calendar is based on the lunar phases, the 15th day of the month will always be a full moon. Firstly, I will be making a lantern to go with my pink Chinese hanfu, which I have chosen to wear this year. I also have my little Chang'e rabbit, which is a must for the festival. There's a lot to be said about this little rabbit, but I'll leave that for another time. Here I have a bamboo hoop and also a material Mabon equinox flower, also known as the spider lily, in a pale pink. Different coloured equinox flowers have different meanings. This pale pink variety represents love, passion, and beauty. I removed the stalk quite easily with just a pull, so that it's ready to attach to the base a little later on. I then attached a pretty pink tassel to the base of the hoop by looping it through a little hole. I then prepared a chain of pearls to attach a handle for my lantern. I will secure this with a little golden ball. For the handle, I have this little wooden stick with a hoop. This will work perfectly. With that securely fastened, it's time for some pink fluff. I originally thought about using white fluff in a circle to represent the moon, but I stayed with the pink theme because I wanted to bring out the nurturing motherly qualities of the moon as a reminder to just be kinder to oneself. When festivals come round, I find things often get very hectic. There's always a lot of rushing around, choosing costumes, mending items, creating new ones, and it can get quite stressful, but I'm really going to embrace each of these moments with this rosy moon lantern. After all, pink is also my favourite colour, so smiles are bound to be all round. It's finally time to fix the equinox flower in place. Next, I chose to add two cute little white rabbits who are on a journey towards each other, to represent the continuous and growing love in all sorts of relations, bringing more kindred spirits my way. Next, I prepared a string of pearls to be draped within the lantern hoop. I find they add a very regal feel to it, as well as much spiritual significance. Pearls symbolise purity, wisdom, and spiritual transformation. They also obviously have links to the moon due to their colour and shape, and possess a very feminine energy, which is perfect for this festival. I then created a central golden hanging with triple pearl chain and a little pink crystal water drop to bring pure joy my way. For these remind me of the tears of joy which come from pure loving energies. And a few more little bells, these bigger than the last. I chose 6 to be hung from a golden crown-like edge. With that, all that's left to add are these few little LED lights on a string, which have this convenient little switch. And my lantern is complete. I've seen many lanterns for the Mid-Autumn Festival in China, but never one with an equinox flower, so I especially wanted to create one of these today. It's also a nod of thanks to someone who was very special to me, who I learnt a lot from. Though some of the lessons were quite challenging, I'll forever be thankful for the strength that came through persevering and finally overcoming the difficulties that they brought me. Next, I created some cute little Chinese-style rabbit clips to go in my hair. I'll be doing an ancient traditional Chinese-inspired hairstyle, so it's always nice to add a few little seasonal accessories. I also created a little pink bag for my phone, as I will be taking a trip into town, and I like to keep it safe and close to me when there are lots of people about. I used 6 poppers to secure the upper edge of the bag, 3 inside and then another 3 on the outer flap, just so it feels extra safe. I finally finished with my mid-autumn crafts. The Mid-Autumn Festival is a major day for celebration. It's a time for moon worship, family reunion, and Thanksgiving. Today, all around China, friends and family will gather together to eat moon cakes and appreciate the magnificent full moon. Speaking of moon cakes, it's time for me to enjoy some myself. Last year in the UK, I made some moon cakes at home. This year, I've been given a box of them from some friends. This one comes in petal pink with little golden rabbits, mountains, and flowers on, which is just perfect to add to this year's rosy theme. Though Mid-Autumn Festival in modern times is celebrated on the 15th day of the 8th month of the lunar calendar, back in ancient times, this festival was actually celebrated at the autumn equinox. The ancient Book of Rites recorded that Tianzi would worship the sun at the March equinox and the moon on the September equinox. Tianzi, Chun, Zhao Ri, Qiu, Xi Yue, Zhao Ri Zhi Zhao, Xi Yue Zhi Xi. This is why I like to call it the Mabon Moon Festival. Inside the box are 8 small pink boxes, each with a different mooncake inside. Here's a sweet purple one. And this one has a date and walnut filling. Taro and chia seed mooncake. Green bean and shredded meat mooncake. Mixed nut mooncake. Date and walnut mooncake. And lastly, mango mooncake. Now let's take a look inside them. I quite enjoyed this taro one. Wasn't so keen on this green bean and shredded meat one. Love the mixed nut. The date and walnut was lovely too. But my very favourite has to be this mango mooncake. It has such a soft, delicate texture that just melts in your mouth. It's definitely my new favourite mooncake. As the golden sun begins to head to sleep, I'm ready for a stroll into town to enjoy the festivities and my newly made craft. Last time I was in China, I celebrated this festival in vibrant red. This time, I'm feeling much calmer in my tranquil pale pink. I stopped for a while beside the lake to admire my newly created lantern. It won't be long until it's dark out, and I can enjoy the lights in all their glory. In China, lanterns have become an essential part of the Mid-Autumn Festival. Carrying little lanterns like mine are highly treasured amongst families and especially children at this time, as they create a very joyful, festive atmosphere. But that's not all. There are several Mid-Autumn legends to do with the moon and those who reside there. One popular story often told at this time is of Chang'e, who is said to have flown to the moon after drinking an elixir of immortality. And so at this time, children often like to carry lanterns to guide her way. The town is filled with many festive stalls, some selling lanterns similar to mine. I also came across some traditional Chinese hairpins and even found a red spider lily one. I stopped to browse the little doll stall. Herbal teas. And even passed a tarot reading stall. It was quite a cloudy night, but I was lucky enough to catch a glimpse of the moon before it was covered in dark clouds. Yay! some snacky snacks. A meeting with the Monkey King. Much walking. More browsing. Some serene gazing. And it was time to slowly head back home through some quieter routes. Although I had a lot of fun, I much prefer time in solitude. Though I was prepared for the hustle and bustle of mid-autumn town life, I was quite surprised at the amount of people and how crowded it was in some areas. I'm sure the numbers must have far exceeded previous years. Returning closer to home, to a more peaceful area and more tranquil state of mind, I slowly walked with my rosy moon lantern, connected through hand and heart, past fluttering lights and over the zigzag bridge. Stopping inside a pavilion beside the lake, I lifted my lantern to bid farewell to the moon, who was still hiding behind dark clouds. Though unseen, she is still there, reflecting light, gentle and bright, a thought I carried in my heart as I slowly returned home. Thank you for joining along with me on today's journey. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and remember to subscribe and comment for more content. And I will see you in my next video. Bye!
The moon, she dances like the waves, like the waves. On the shore, making circles, like the waves, like the waves, on the shore.